Fist, forged in shattered torches and a dark dystopian world full of furtizens, fighting against the evil machina. Your play is Raiden, a worn out, fed up veteran, taking up arms again to rescue his friends. And did I mention he's also a bunny? Welcome to Dave's Reviews, where we play random games in front of a live audience and then review them for your future reference. Help out the community and let us know what you think of Fist, Forged, and Shadow Torch in the comments below. For the end of this review, you decide to play Fist, Forged, and Shadow Torch, we ask only for a thumbs up. Fist, Forged, and Shadow Torch? I'm only going to say Fist from now on. Has released on the Xbox Game Pass 2 years after its original debut. An indie game developed by the Chinese-based TI Games, whose only other project is Ancient Emulator VR? It's sure to amaze you in this emotional, fun, and beautiful game running on Unreal Engine 4. Venturing through the dieselpunk world, you'll use an assortment of tools to fight against the Iron Dogs, and in a fantastic move, you'll need them to traverse and unlock areas of the world as well. Your toolkit will be loaded with a super-powered robotic fist, an overclocked mining drill, stun batons, and a homing missile, allowing for destruction at every distance. Your Batman utility belt has charges that can be expended for limited actions, such as deflecting and healing. You have to use them wisely, as you only have a limited number of charges that are shared across the entire utility belt. However, replenishing the charges is pretty straightforward, and you'll find plentiful pickups and executions will restore a charge too, after you unlock the required ability. Abilities are available for unlock at the many checkpoint stations found throughout the map, and will cost you some of the currency you've collected from destroying the Iron Dogs. But some of them also require a data disk, which are only retrievable from one of the many bosses. The bosses of Fist are varied experiences, some requiring high levels of precision, perfectly timed combos, such as this house 10,000 thing. Others, unfortunately, aren't that exciting to beat and later become generic enemies in the Legion of the Iron Dogs. Platforming is a large part of this game, more so than the combat. Whilst you'll gain the skills for combat quickly, as there isn't much variation in the combos you'll do, platforming will take some practice. Over the course of the story, you unlock the ability to glide, double jump, wall ride, dash, and more to traverse the treacherous town and its nooks and crannies. There are many collectibles to find, including posters that unlock cosmetic changes, news articles that include some lore and background commentary, and most important, are the extracts. Upon finding 3 of these, you'll get a permanent increase to your maximum health. It is nice to see that your combat arsenal also allows you to unlock new areas and assist in traversing the map. There's no reason to stop and ask why you couldn't progress. I like that Fist is not a punishing game. You will not be drastically punished for jumping off edges or testing if certain obstacles will hurt or kill you. In the cases I found, I was just teleported back to the safest platform with a health reduction. There was, however, one odd thing we found during our playthrough. Let me play a clip and see if you notice anything.
Stomach, and I'm like,
I don't think that was a stomach there, babe.
And the keys, darling. Thank you.
Did you catch it? Let me get real close to the mic for this one. They made the only female character have shaved arms. In a town full of furries, the only female character has shaved arms. Why? Why? Fist will have you entertained for about 12 to 20 hours, depending on how much of a treasure hunter you are. It's a moderately hard game, with a touching story, and definitely something you should play casually, laid back on the couch, beer in hand. The DLG rating for Fist is 9 out of 10 for platforming, 7 out of 10 for combat, and 7 out of 10 for story. We originally played this game live over on Twitch, and were able to gather immediate feedback from you, our community. If you'd like to participate in that conversation, and have a chance of having your thoughts featured on the video, there will be a link to the stream and the game in the description below. If this review helped answer your burning questions about Fist, please like the video as it helps us out quite a bit. If you want to see our next review for Exo Primal, hit the subscribe button so you get notified when it's out.